In this particular video lecture, let us try to find whether the given structure is statically determinate or indeterminate, and also we will be finding the degree of indeterminacy if the structure is statically indeterminate. First, let us consider this simply supported beam. One end is hinged and another end is roller. So we know that in this particular end, two reactions are possible. One is vertical, one is horizontal. So in this roller end, only one reaction is possible, that is a vertical reaction. And for beams, we know that whether to call the given beam as statically determinate or indeterminate, there is a formula. If R is equal to 3 times N, then it is called as a statically determinate structure. If number of reactions R is greater than 3N, then it is called statically indeterminate structure. So number of reactions here R equal to 2 plus 1, that is equal to 3. And we know equilibrium equations available equal to 3 because it's a 2D structure. Therefore, number of parts N equal to 1. From here to here only it is considered as a single part, so n equal to 1. So we have here R equal to 3n, so 3 equal to 3 into 1, 3 is equal to 3, or 3 minus 3 is equal to 3, sorry, 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. So the structure is statically determinate, the degree of indeterminacy is equal to 0. Now, the second problem you see here, a propped cantilever, one end is fixed, the other end is a roller end. So here, at the fixed end, three reactions are possible, vertical, horizontal and a moment. And at this roller end, only one reaction is possible, that is a vertical reaction. So number of reaction equal to 3 plus 1, 3 at this end and 1 is at this end. So totally R is equal to 3, number of parts is equal to 1. So we have the equation R equal to 3N, or R minus 3N is equal to 0. So 4 equal to 3 into 1, so 4 minus 3 will give you 1. So the structure is statically indeterminate, therefore degree of indeterminacy is equal to 1. If you get a condition where R is equal to 3N, then only you can call it as a statically determinate structure. If R works out to be greater than 3N, for example in this case 4 is greater than 3, so it is called statically indeterminate structure, and the difference between them is nothing but degree of indeterminacy. Next problem you see here, a continuous beam. This is a hinge, this is a roller, and again a roller. Number of reactions possible is equal to 2 plus 1 plus 1, so total is 4. Therefore, number of parts is equal to 1 here. From here to here, it is considered as a single part. Therefore, we have R equal to 3N. So, 4 equal to 3 into 1. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So, it is a statically indeterminate structure, and degree of indeterminacy is equal to 1. Let us take one more problem here. So one end is fixed, the other two ends are roller. So here I can have three reactions, here one, here one. So totally number of reactions is equal to 5. Number of parts is taken as 1 from here to here. And you may get a doubt, sir, there are two parts. No, the number of parts from here to here is taken as 1. Only if the internal hinges or internal rollers are present, then only the number of parts will increase. So here R is equal to 3N, so 5 equal to 3 into 1, 5 minus 3 equal to 2, it is a statically indeterminate structure, and degree of indeterminacy is equal to 2. Now one more problem you see here. In this particular problem, one end is fixed, the other end you can see here, the moment is restrained and the vertical reaction is also restrained, or vertical moment is restrained, only it can move horizontally. So here three reactions, here you can get two reactions, one is vertical and the other one is a moment, horizontal is allowed at this particular end. So therefore number of reaction equal to 3 plus 2, 5, number of parts is 1, so degree of indeterminacy is equal to 2, it is a statically indeterminate structure. Now this problem, here we have a hinged end here, and an internal hinge is provided here. So whenever an internal hinge is provided, in the previous lecture we have seen that the equation is R plus I equal to 3N. I is nothing but the number of internal reactions you are going to get at that particular internal hinge. So here you can expect two reactions. One is a moment and the other one is a horizontal reaction, because vertical moment is allowed here and this is a hinge. So obviously here two reactions, so 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, number of reactions equal to 4, number of internal reaction I equal to 2. Here the moment is allowed, but the other two reactions are, the other two translations are not allowed. That means here one vertical reaction and one internal horizontal reaction will be occurring. So you will get R plus I equal to 3N. So 4 plus 2 equal to 3 into 2. So 6 equal to 6. It is a statically determinate structure and degree of indeterminacy is equal to 0 here. This problem you see here, both ends are fixed and in between that we have two internal hinges. So three reactions at this end and three reactions at this end, totally six reactions. And I is nothing but totally we have two internal hinges. So two reactions here, two reactions here. So totally four internal reactions. So number of part is equal to 1, 2 and 3. So number of part equal to 3. R plus I equal to 3N we have. So 6 plus 4 equal to 3 into 3. So 10 minus 9 equal to 1. It is a statically indeterminate structure and degree of indeterminacy equal to 1. One more problem we can see here. This particular problem, one end is hinged, this end is also hinged. Here you have two internal hinges, here you have a roller. So two reactions here, one reaction here, and again two reactions here. So totally five reactions we are getting, and internal reactions here, two internal hinges we have, therefore four internal reactions we will get. So number of parts is equal to, from here to here it is one, this is second and this is third. So totally we have three parts. So 5 plus 4 equal to 3 into 3 or 9 minus 9 equal to 0. It is a statically determinate structure and degree of indeterminacy is equal to 0. Now one more problem we can see here. This end is fixed, the other end is hinged, and in between that we have an internal roller. Always remember that internal roller will create only one internal reaction. So here number of reaction equal to 3 and 2, so it is 5. Internal reaction is 1, number of part, this is one part, this is another part, so two parts. So 5 plus 1 equal to 3 into 2, that is 6 minus 6 equal to 0. So it is statically determinate and degree of indeterminacy is equal to 0. This problem you see here, this end is fixed and these two are roller. So here number of reaction equal to 3 plus 1 plus 1, totally 5. Number of part equal to 1, because there is no internal hinge or there is no internal roller. So number of the equation for finding the indeterminacy is R equal to 3N, number of reaction equal to 5, number of part equal to 1. So 5 equal to 3 into 1. So 5 minus 3 equal to 2. So it is statically indeterminate structure. You will get it as statically determinate if you get this answer as 0 only. So the degree of indeterminacy here is equal to 2. So this is how you can find whether the given problem is statically determinate or indeterminate. If it is indeterminate, we can find the degree of indeterminacy. In the coming video lectures, we will take the problems of frames and also we will take the problems of trusses. Thank you.